You come highly recommended, Doctor. I hope you consider our offer seriously.
Not to worry, General, Tiny gleefully interrupted. Dr. Fountain agreed to work on Operation Small Change at breakfast this morning.
My smirk broadened into an all-out goofy grin, shamelessly excessive. I still had a buzz from the check I'd received.
Well, well,
General Killjoy looked at me in genuine astonishment.
Congratulations! Welcome to the Millionaires Club!
He extended his hand to shake mine, but tightened his grasp prematurely, thus catching only my fingers in his bruising grip. He let go immediately, homophobic disgust coloring his bellicose features.
I'll be damned, though, he said, wiping his hand on his jacket. I thought you'd be a harder nut to crack.
No, was all I could think to say. 47.
Let's get down to business, then.
General Killjoy slapped his knees.
What we have created is the ideal incapacitating agent, just as you read in the letter.
An incapacitating, non-terminating agent, Tiny echoed.
This sort of research, General Killjoy talked over him, you may or may not know, has been going on since World War II. As we said, it originally focused on chemical incapacitants, but these always presented problems. It was impossible to guarantee dosage, so they were very unreliable in their effects and duration. The biggest issue, however, was that they required the dropping of a bomb, or at least spraying by planes, and hence were not terribly covert. Contaminating the water supply had its problems as well, since the presence of chlorine, fertilizer, and other water pollutants often reacted with the incapacitating compound. Our viral incapacitant has none of these problems.